In the last video, we made a simple house model, and now we need to turn it into a textured house so it helps us save a lot of time in the illustration process. Well, to do that involves taking very flat photos, they're called texture photos actually, and applying them onto the 3D form inside Sketchup. So let's take a look at how that works. And this is another one of those areas where I'm going to spend a little extra time up front and then have some nice kit pieces that I can make all sorts of stuff out of. So I'm going to make them with flexibility in mind and spend a little extra time so I can save way more time later. The first idea was, what materials am I going to use? And since my sketch didn't have many particular details, it came down to finding reference on the internet of the sort of real-world buildings I wanted to use. And they also gave me a bit of a color palette to work from. So with these in mind, I went to cgtextures.com and got some free texture samples to work with. So you're looking at two basic types of textures I've made here. On the left, these are unique textures, which means they don't particularly repeat well. They look like a specific wall, and I'll probably use them to fill most of a wall. On the right, though, you see some more generic-looking construction materials. These are what are called repeat tiles. These are textures that I could expand them in either direction, and they would seamlessly repeat. And this is really helpful for generic buildings where a lot of the town is built from a few materials. So I've got a few different type of roof tiles, and then those bricks that look similar to the ones you found in the reference. I've laid them out here for the ease of the video, but actually they're all individual files. So let's take a look at how these sorts of images work in a 3D texture. Here's the simple house that we made in the last video, and I've already pre-made some materials for texturing the first three houses. And if you take a look at the materials palette, you can see little samples of the texture images that I've turned into SketchUp materials. So to start off, I'm going to have a base tile for the whole building. So I'll select all the faces, get out my paint bucket, and choose the repeating brick tile. So this is where a repeat is really nice, because you can't tell where the seams are. I could expand this building as big as I wanted, and those bricks would continue everywhere. So tiles are good for generic stuff, but it's also good to sort of counterbalance the generic stuff with some specific stuff. So for this door, I can select the face and choose a different material. And I know that this material has a door on it, but it's the wrong size, as you can see here. So I can right-click, say texture, position. And this allows me to alter the size and scale of the texture on the model. And when I'm happy with it, I just click anywhere else and it confirms it. I'm also going to do the same for a window. And on this one, I'll use a different material that I know has a window in it. So I just find the window in the image, scale it to match, and then click outside. And I didn't quite get it there, so I'll reposition it a little bit. All right. So you can see now why those materials were good to have the straight on camera. Because if those materials I made in Photoshop had a skew to them, it'd be hard to line these up. They have to be isometric texture photos or a straight on camera. So I'll use a different door for this one. And for these windows, I'll use that same material. It's got some nice windows in it. So sometimes when you make your textures, you keep this in mind that you won't be using the whole thing at one time. Instead, you'll maybe just be using tiny little chunks of it. So there's sort of an abstract art to creating texture images. And it's good to know what the general properties are before you set out. And there I've just copied one window to become the second window's texture. And for this inset window here, I think I'm actually going to use a different type of brick, as if there used to be windows there, and then they got boarded up. So I'll position it a little bit here to focus on those bricks. All right. And then I want to make this back wall an entirely different material to give the building a little bit of character. And I'll use that same brick material here, but I definitely need to change the orientation and scale it up a bit. And when I'm happy with the building as a whole, I can select all the faces, including the roofs, and make it a component. And this is important because this is going to make it part of my building library. So then when I go to populate the whole street, this is just like a little Lego house that I can snap into place. And it'll help me turn a very long job into a short one. And you'll see that in the upcoming video.